Hello everyone. After we set up this aquarium, Folkerscape, this aquarium with some nice plants, rocks and wood, we would like to explain you the three types or three ways to put carbon in your aquarium. Folker, we have the three types here from Denele. We have here the most easy way to put carbon in the aquarium. It's called Carbo Elixir Bio.
Yes.
Can you explain how this works?
This is completely easy. You put it out from the box and then you have bottle opened and
just drop it in?
Only drop it in.
How many drops per liter?
6 drops per 10 liters.
All right.
And it's completely, this is the easiest way for bringing carbon to
the plants. Because the plants need carbon to grow, they feed on carbon. It's like humans, we eat a lot, and the plants also need something to eat, so they feed on this carbon. And this is especially, this one is for beginners, right? Because it's the easiest way to bring CO2 or carbon to the aquarium.
That's right.
What is the next thing? This is also an easy one.
This is
also for beginners or for children especially, because it's very safe.
Yes, very safe. Yes,
right.
it's our bio CO2. This is the easiest way for bring CO2 in your aquarium. And we have here.
We already mounted this up. We set it up already.
Yeah. You have, I unpacked. You have in the package one bottle and in this bottle, we prepared with a special
gel.
And in the head,
if you open it, you have something like a pill or a little capsule. What is in this capsule or this pill? It looks like a pill, you know?
Yes, yeast in the...
There's yeast inside there.
It's yeast inside.
So you have to open it.
Yeah, you open it.
Just open. Break the capsule and just pour everything inside.
And the rest...
Put the capsule also inside, right?
And then you refilled.
You just close it or
No. We must, before we fill it with water, we have here a level.
You fill it up with water to the arrow, so nearly full, and then it's done, right?
It's done.
And just you close it.
Important is don't shake it.
Don't shake it, and you see, as you can see here, there's a hose coming out. This is a bubble counter behind, and this is the easy way to bring carbon to your aquarium. As the third option, this is the more professional. Like, I mean, I use that a lot. I use these kind of bottles that are refillable with CO2, and I use them in all my tanks, to be honest. I use the more professional type because these bottles, they last longer.
Yeah.
Is that true? I mean, you have this one that's, when it's over, it's over, it's gone. This one lasts about 30 days, like 4 weeks.
Yeah.
Approximately. But this can go up, this is also for bigger tanks, this can last 3 months, depending how much CO2 you want to put in your tank, depending how big your tank is. But for my nano tanks, this can go up to 3 months.
Yeah.
So, let's show the system. What is in the box?
In the box, we have...
This is the system. It's like a bottle that is refillable, right?
Yes.
You have a regulator.
Regulator, then you have a stand for...
Yeah, the stand, you should use it or you don't have to use it depending on... And of course, you have the flipper to count the bubbles.
Yeah, and in the set is also the checker for your...
You can check the CO2 that is in the water.
That's right, yes. There you have...
Some liquid?
Liquid.
Like an indicator?
Yeah, indicator, and this liquid, it's in the start is blue. Blue is no CO2 in your tank. Green is perfect level on CO2 in your tank, and when this liquid gets
yellow,
then it's too much CO2 in your tank.
So you can check easily how much CO2 is in the tank.
Yes.
Would you like to show how this works?
Yeah.
Just open it, put the liquid inside, it's and then we... Put it in the aquarium. It's very easy.
You open it.
You open this capsule. It's a capsule as well.
Yes. Then you open this one. Put the liquid inside.
And just close it.
And close it. And put
that's it.
That's it.
So it's easy going, as you see. The most easy method of see how much or check how much CO2 you have in your tank.
Okay, now we have one thing. In the night, the plants don't need CO2. And for this one, we have a special
magnetic valve. So this shuts down the CO2
in the night. Yes.
All right. So if you want to spare some CO2, because like Volker said, in the nights the plants don't consume any CO2, you can spare, because why you should use it if the plants don't need it? You can use this little device. It's also some kind of regulator. It shuts down the CO2 during the night, so we spare some CO2.
Yes.
That's true. So guys, we have three systems, or three ways how you could put CO2 in your tanks. I hope you like it. Keep on growing plants. Thanks a lot for watching.
Ciao.